morning, everybody, and welcome to the vlog, Reptile Army. Guess what, guys? Our last baby snakes of the year hatch, and we've had some bangers, including this clutch right here. Look at these things. Unfrickin' believable. I mean, I don't even know where to start, to be honest with you. I mean, I'll start right here with just a pinstripe cypress ball python. So again, just a two-gene animal, nothing too crazy right there. This is actually kind of an interesting animal here. This is actually an Enchi pinstripe cypress ball python that has a pretty reduced pattern. Looks like there might be some Woma ball in this as well, so that might be a Woma. We have just a black pewter cypress here, which is a pastel, a black pastel, and a cypress right there. Absolute beauty. And then we get into silver madness over here. We might as well go ahead and start with this one right here. This is actually what they would call a silver streak vanilla cypress ball python. So the silver streak is actually a super pastel black pastel, then it's a vanilla, and then it's a cypress. And oh my gosh, that snake is incredible. And then you look at this one right here. This is another silver streak, it's another vanilla, and then this is actually a pinstripe cypress as well. So wow, that is incredible. And then this little monkey right here, I'm going to be honest with you, I'm not sure why it's patternless. This again is a silver streak cypress pinstripe vanilla, but why is it patternless and the other one had some pattern? I'm not 100% sure, but that snake is an absolute ripper. And then of course we have a couple other just really beautiful animals here. This would just be a black pewter, which is a pastel and a black pastel. It's a vanilla and it's a cypress. And then finally we have, again, a black pewter, pastel, black pastel, a pinstripe, and a cypress ball python. But oh my gosh, we actually had the last three clutches hatched today, and this one was an absolute ripper. So yesterday I actually rearranged all of the female ball pythons. You see all the new orange tags that are my breeding plans and stuff like that. Now today I actually have to arrange all the males to basically coordinate the females, right? So basically male number one right here, which is a pastel leopard clown, he's not number one in the breeding scheme this year. As a matter of fact, a sunset ball python is number one. So what I have to do is go number one to number one, number two to number two, and so on and so forth. So it makes it really easy when I'm actually putting males in or taking males out, where I know that, like, all right, if I'm group three, it's the third male. I don't have to look for it and search where it's at and stuff like that. So now all I have to do is just really rearrange all my males, and then the breeding plans are done. I mean, we're ready to go. We're gonna feed tomorrow, and then after they get done feeding in the next day or two, I'll let them settle for a day or two, males will go in. So within the next 3-4 days tops, we're gonna have male ball pythons in with females. But for now, one last tax, rearrange all these males. And that's a wrap. Males are all organized, females are all organized, so we are ready to go with the breeding season. Again, I'm gonna feed tomorrow, let them rest for a day or so, and then Cinny Sunset, the first time he's ever been in with a female, will be in group run at the end and go down the list. So it's gonna be an absolute banger of a year. I mean, I hope so anyways. We're gonna work our butts off to make some amazing animals. Like I said, huge upgrade in quality of males and a bunch of females this year, so we should have some really pretty amazing clutches. This is a huge thing off my plate. So happy that now it's the fun part. You know, you guys need your daily dose of anacondas, right? You know, I always have to show my anacondas every day because I love them so much. But the fact is that Jazzy here, my male, that, by the way, seems to never climb out of the water. Ariana's over here, Ivy is over here, but Jazz is always in the water. He finally shed out. So now all three of my anacondas have shed just within the last few days, which means that we're gonna go ahead and feed them. So in the next couple days, we'll throw out food. Now, Ivy is going to get a giant pig this time because it's been a while since she's ate a big meal. Ariana will get a nice sized pig. Jazzy will get some food. So all three anacondas are going to get fed. But pretty darn cool that all of the anacondas are shed out and ready to get fed. I hope you guys are excited about it. This was that interesting clutch that we caught here recently that was actually dual fathered, but more importantly, was dual fathered from sperm retention from a year before, because it actually bred to a bamboo vanilla Woma. And this is happens to be a little bamboo vanilla Woma here, which is just absolutely gorgeous. So this is the male that fathered from this year in 2021. Well, the year before I actually bred a super Enchi pinstripe to this female. Now, I didn't do it this year, I did it last year, and sure enough, he ended up fathering a bunch of animals as well. So this is actually a Enchi pinstripe here, meaning that, of course, the Super Enchi pin father from the year before, everything is going to be Enchi and some are going to be pinned. So we had that one and we had another one too, which again was just an Enchi pinstripe as well. Then it gets a little bit more interesting where we got just a normal Enchi ball python, again, fathered by the Super Enchi pinstripe, obviously, but then we end up having a pastel ball python, right? Now this is really interesting because, again, the female and the male from the year before didn't have pastel in it, and I didn't think the male from this year had pastel in it. So where this pastel came from, I'm not sure. There's a chance that that vanilla bambuoma actually is a pastel vanilla bambuoma. So my guess is that two of these animals were fathered by the pastel vanilla bambuoma, and then the other two were fathered by the previous year's father. So ball python is going to be absolutely incredible. Again, these guys just hatched out. We've got two more clutches to hatch out, and then it is done for the year. So we'll get these guys set up and get them feeding here. They'll be up on the website in probably 2 or 3 weeks. So we're breeding the mangroves, and we actually have Khalifa here, which is a mangrove that I believe is a male. I'm almost positive it's a male, and we're going to need all the males we can get because we actually have quite a few females, to be honest with you. So I'm going to just try to get him out without him biting me. Come on, little buddy, where you at? And I'm just going to really quick look at the tail length, and this is actually a pretty docile one, to be totally honest with you. I can look at the tail length right here, and you can see that long, slow taper. That's where the hemipene pockets are, right there. So this, of course, is a boy. We only have two other boys that are breeding like 10 females. So it's gonna be really good to get him over to BHB and have him part of the rotation. It's gonna be a bummer to actually take him off display because he's such a cool animal. But the truth is, because it's rear fang venomous, we don't take him out for the public anyways. So we're gonna probably, whoa! And that's why we don't take them out for the public, is because sometimes these guys can get a little bit cheeky. And we're going to actually move the multi-cinta into this enclosure because it's getting bigger and it's going to look absolutely incredible. But for now, Khalifa's going over and being part of BHB and hopefully making some babies.
Today we're going to be fixing up Khalifa's cage. Khalifa, the mangrove snake, we took off just so we could add it to our breeding program. So we're going to move the multi-cinta into this cage. So let's get started. Looks great, doesn't it? I can't wait to see this guy in there.
You wanna go into your little thing?
He looks so good in there with all the green.
So many people ask me about my long hair. You know, I've been growing my hair since I was 10 years old, and I always say I'm like Samson, right? If I cut my hair off, I lose my strength and stuff like that. And one of my biggest fears, not that there's anything wrong with it, but one of my biggest fears was always losing my hair, right? Because I've always had it, and it's always been such a big part of my personality, right? Ironically enough, iRestore actually reached out to me and sent me this really cool gadget here. Listen, I'm not losing my hair right now, but I wouldn't mind making a little bit more full and stuff like that. This is an FDA cleared, clinical proven system to grow hair back in as little as 3 months and works for both men and women. I guess what you do is you just basically put this on like this, you hit go, and you do this for 25 minutes. It has like lasers in it and stuff like that that basically help the hair grow. They sent me a whole bunch of other stuff like gummies and shampoo and serum to keep my hair luscious and long. And I'm telling you, it's going, I don't even know it's on my head. So it's actually pretty cool. I don't think I'm losing my hair, but what can it possibly hurt? Maybe I'll be even better here in a month or two. iRestore is a leading device on the market that combines 282 medical grade lasers and LEDs to provide the correct light output and power level to stimulate your hair follicles. Just like at the doctor's office, but in the comfort of your own home. Similar to how a plant absorbs nutrition for water, the light energy from the iRestore is absorbed by the hair follicles. This stimulates cellular activity and helps distribute blood and nutrients to hair follicles to promote hair regrowth. With its unique design, iRestore allows for a maximum scalp coverage using it just 25 minutes a day. 3 times a week, you can start seeing results as little as 3 months. Its hands-free design and built-in timer allows you to get treatment while going about your daily routine. iRestore can be used in conjunction with topical treatments, hair transplants, PRP treatments, etc. to promote and maximize hair growth and to maintain the health of new hair. I tell you what, definitely need a full head of hair, so you can actually go to the link in the description, use my promo code BrianB, and you can save $350. That's right, the link in the description using my promo code BrianB, and you can save $350 off your purchase. And I always talk about how when you fear things, it's usually the lack of knowledge, you know, and I'll be honest with you, I've been saying for a long time that I really was freaked out by legless lizards, and by getting Vlad, it's really been kind of a changing thing because I gained a lot of knowledge. You know, I learned about the actual animals themselves, you know, where they're from, their husbandry, all kinds of stuff. But then on top of it, I kind of learned the mannerisms, which is interesting because these guys will do things like where their defense is to kind of roll and twist. It's just interesting when you're holding it a certain way, you see how it kind of twists like that? It's really an interesting animal. And when you get to kind of know it, it's not nearly as scary. And I've actually kind of gotten to a point where I really love them, to be honest with you. And I'd actually like to get a mate for Vlad, to be honest with you, because I think it'd be interesting to maybe breed these guys one day and see that whole experience, because the majority of the animals that you see when it comes to legless lizards are actually imported wild animals. Not a lot of people are breeding them, and I think some captive babies would be really, really cool. But again, it just continues to show you, I did it with arachnids, where I was terrified of arachnids and now I love them. And then I was kind of freaked out by legless lizards like Vlad, and now I think that they're absolutely amazing. You see that little twist there? It's so bizarre that they do that, but I definitely have kind of fallen in love with these guys, and we definitely want to work with more of them. And there's other species of legless lizards too that are really cool that maybe we'll get into as well when we do the expansion. But nevertheless, when you're freaked out by something, I'm telling you, if you learn as much as you can about it and create knowledge, you will actually start to love it, just like I have this guy. Just a couple weeks away from Gemma potentially laying eggs, but I wanted to explain something that I think is pretty cool, something you'll notice if you ever breed snakes, is that, you know, since we got Gemma, she always spent time on this side of the cage. Well, every enclosure here at the Reptarium has a hot spot and a cold side, right? So we want the ambient on the cold side to be about 80, 82 degrees, but then we want the hot spot to be 90 to 95 degrees. Now, again, she liked it on the cool side of the cage and spent every single day there. Well, sure enough, after she shed and she's getting ready to kind of lay pretty soon, she moved over to the hot side of the cage and has not moved from this coil for the last 3 or 4 days. So that's kind of what happens, right? They thermoregulate to kind of grow their eggs, right? So you can definitely see a lot of distension in her. You can see she's coming up. Now, I'm gonna be totally honest with you. I still don't know if they're gonna be fertile or not. We won't know until she actually lays eggs. And unfortunately, we're going on a trip to Florida here pretty soon. We're gonna be at Gatorland on the 11th for Crocfest. So if you wanna come meet us and hang out with us at Crocfest, great conservation for crocodilians. People from all over the world come for this Crocfest. It's gonna be really amazing. So I'm hoping that we are in Florida when Gemma lays, because no one here could pull the clutch. And of course, I wanna be here. So I hope she either lays before we leave for Florida or after we get back from Florida. Either way, it's gonna be exciting, but praying for good eggs, there's no doubt about it. But I wanted to share with you that interesting thing where she went from the cool side of the cage to the hot side of the cage for that thermal regulation to kind of help her eggs develop. So fingers crossed we're gonna have some good eggs before I leave for Florida. And then the last baby ball pythons, baby snakes at all that are gonna be born this year are right here, and they are some rippers. I got just actually a normal Enchi pinstripe, actually two of them here, right here. Again, just two gene animals, Enchi incomplete dominant and pinstripe incomplete dominant. Then you start getting into some really beautiful stuff like this. This is actually a spinner blast Enchi extreme gene. So it's a pastel, it's a pinstripe, it's a spider, it's an Enchi, and it is extreme gene. And then you really start reducing the pattern with this one, which is actually a super Enchi pinstripe extreme gene. Just look at the little dotting on it. Absolutely incredible. And then to take it one step further, we hatched out two of these, which is just like that last one, but adding the spider gene into it. So again, it is a spider, it's a pinstripe, it's a super Enchi, and they are both extreme genes. Wow, these things turned out incredible. And the last baby snakes to crawl out of the egg for the year. And you guys know, we're just starting breeding again. So the cycle begins once again, and it won't be long before we're getting eggs and getting more babies. So it's that time of year again, and people are sending us gifts, which I appreciate. Yeah. I love you guys. P.O. Box down below. It's always, we always love your stuff. So what do you think we've got?
I think we have candy bars.
Oh yeah, it says candy bars. Oh, wait, it says, what is it? 150. It's 150 candy bars? No, I don't know what that is.
Maybe that's the money. Wash your hands.
I'm a maniac when it comes to knives. You guys know that. And you guys send us stuff from different countries. We do these mukbangs over on Noah's channel, so go check that out. I'll link in the description. You can go check it out. Well, oh my gosh. I've never seen Swedish candy before.
Yeah, you're just gonna throw a card. I know.
Me first.
I got so excited.
Oh, there's a scoreboard.
Oh, wow. he even did a
scoreboard. What? Yeah, Brian, Lori, Noah. Oh my gosh, I don't even know how to pronounce these. Marabu Majak Kalak?
Yeah, that's
well,
it.
That sounds about right.
We can Google translate that. It's clearly Google Swedish.
So what do we got?
Hi, Brian. We love all that you do at the Riptarium and wanted to give extra thank you for the daily inspiration and positive vibes you give on the vlog. Lori, you said on the podcast while testing beef jerky that you and Noah and Brian would do something on the podcast such as food reviews. So we're sending you this box from our country, Sweden. Their most popular candy and Fika.
Ooh, I like it. But well, we'll definitely, should we do it on the podcast or do it on Noah's channel?
It says on the podcast.
Well, we'll do it either. Yeah, we'll probably do it. Let's do it over on Noah's channel. It'll just be so much fun. That way we can do it over there. So, yeah, let's do that. But,
Ooh, this is going to be.
Are we going to look real quick? Just real quick?
Yeah, let's look at this stuff.
There's the marabou.
This is delicious bowl.
Oh, delicious bowl. Pumpkin pie for my dad, favorite.
It's not pumpkin. No. This looks like sugar. I like sugar. We've tested candy from so many different countries, but never from Sweden. So
I like it.
That's great. So again, we'll do a mukbang over on Noah's channel. By the way, guess what we have? Another box that says Bad Choice Noah.
Bad Choice Noah.
And this one is from where? Columbus, Ohio. So if we ever tasted Columbus, Ohio food, go Buckeyes. Okay, so what do we have?
Noah, Brian, and Lori, enjoy the snacks with original CD. Of when I was young. Wait a minute.
Oh, so this is like some music? So this is like music, man. Look at this.
So we've got to play the CD.
Only children, 3 years it says.
While we taste. Is that how this goes?
This is a little sketch.
A special ornament for Lori.
Wait, why'd you read that?
Aww.
It's
nice.
A Drogo.
It's a little Drogo. Love it. So we've got salted caramel cookies. Those look absolutely fantastic. Ooh, wow. Peanut butter. I love. Oh,
peanut butter pretzels.
Peanut butter pretzels.
You kidding me right now? Ghost pepper cashews. Mm, and I did hot noodles last night.
Oh, yeah.
It was a mistake.
12 at night in the bathroom.
Blueberry Blaze trail mix. That actually looks good. So again, we'll do this over on Noah's channel. Maybe we'll do the two together. I don't even know what it is, but we'll do that. So this is Australia. Are these all for us?
I sure hope
so. I've been so good this whole November, I didn't eat junk.
Good thing it's over.
Oh, wait a second. We got a book.
Oh, yeah.
Got a book first to Brian. Oh, my gosh. Check this out. The Emerald Saga. Book 2 of the Emerald Saga.
Whoa, he sent us.
It looks cool. Whatever it is, I like it.
Send us meds.
Have me read.
I hope this finds you well. My name is Alex Gordon, an actor and author. Wow. Here in Victoria, Australia, we have the longest lockdown in the world for over a year. I'm sorry about that. For the past 2 years, when I started a path to become an actor, the virus hit. All work is gone. In spite of this, I was able to continue my full-time job until lockdown. Number 7, I think. I came across your YouTube channel, spent a little bit of time watching even the older videos. When I saw the hardship you had gone through and documented, it was the point where I thought that I could fight back. I started my own YouTube channel, and once a week I give weekly updates on my life as an actor and author. I will make it to the USA next year, and you will be the first port of call, and you may get a story out of me. I love it. Thank you so much. So what do we have?
You know he's Australian because in the second sentence of the book, there's the word mate.
Mate?
Yeah. She takes her mate's head off her paw and lays it on his left
paw. This is dope, though. That's it. I mean, this guy wrote
his
book.
Yeah.
That's incredible. I can't wait. So I don't know why I got book 2. Why didn't I get book 1?
But I look that up.
We have your favorite, though.
Oh, gotcha, Tim Tam.
Oh, Tim Tam, Tim Tam.
And guess what? Tim-tams. There's 6
oh,
of them.
Oh, my gosh.
Oh, my gosh. You have no idea.
6 Tim Tams.
That's a lot.
Double-coated.
He said in the thing it was actually.
Can we open one of them right now? I'm running low on blood sugar.
Go ahead.
Let's do a double coat.
All right.
Okay, let's do a double coat.
Super bad for you.
Yeah.
Dude, I'm so hungry. I just like.
Yeah, and this is good when you're hungry to eat chocolate. Mm.
Mom? Mm.
I'm good.
My goodness. No.
As he chokes.
Ooh. Oh, that's good.
So thank you guys for sending this stuff. We'll definitely be doing mukbangs over on Noah's channel. Again, link in the description. Let's have some fun with it. I appreciate you guys. Again, PO Box is down there too. So happy holidays.
Oh, the food gloves.
Wait, they taste good, huh?
That's very good.
You're now officially Australian.
Oh, hell yeah. Mate.
So that's it, guys. No more baby snakes for the year. But hey, we're getting into the breeding season within a couple days. So if the cycle starts over, I hope that you enjoyed watching all the babies that we hatched. I certainly did. As a matter of fact, if you enjoyed baby snakes, here's a playlist with tons of baby snakes in it. Could you do me a favor? Could you subscribe to this channel right over here? It would mean the world to me. Have an absolutely amazing day, Reptile Army. Remember, be kind to someone, and I promise I'll see you in the next one.